Thank you for attending. We'll be beginning in just a few minutes. Please, if you are attending, make sure you have your candle beside you, your tea, an object that reminds you of Eleanor, and cozy in with a warm blanket in a spot that you feel most comfortable in. of you joining in, please make sure you have your candle, your object that reminds you of Eleanor, and a cup of tea available. We'll be starting very shortly.
I'm Megan. I'll be your celebrant for today. Eleanor, your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure. You are loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. Thank you for inviting me to share and to honor Eleanor's life today. We'd like everyone to feel comfortable during the ceremony, so please find a cozy chair to sit in, wrap yourself in a blanket, and be sure that you have the items that we listed in the invitation close by. I've had a chance to connect with Eleanor's family, and with every story, every memory, every smile shared, I knew that her life was a life well lived. Eleanor grew up in a small village in northern England near the Scottish border. She and her brothers, who are joining us here today, loved the beautiful countryside and the quiet pace of life. Eleanor moved to Canada after university, where she met Doug and settled down with their two daughters. She worked as a nurse at our local hospital. And even after she retired, she continued to offer her time and energy to the hospital foundation. She had a wonderful group of friends, many of which are joining us today. And in chatting with you some of you earlier, it became clear that Eleanor was a connector and a caregiver. She looked after her friends and her family with such a natural ease, and it was impossible to say no to her. She loved playing tennis and bridge with her friends and spending time down by the ocean. Both of Eleanor's daughters are here today, and they also told me about her love of the sea. There's something magical about living near water, she would always say. Her late husband, Doug, loved to join her for walks on the seawall and find a bench to sit on and soak in the natural beauty of this land. When I asked Eleanor's daughter about their mom's life, they both instantly smiled. It was a good life, full of travel and adventure, love and good food. She loved cooking, almost as much as she loved an afternoon cuppa. She would pour herself the same tea the same way each day, enjoying the process as much as she enjoyed the tea itself. It's been difficult to lose Eleanor during these strange times. Hard to weave together when we're forced to stay apart. And yet, almost as if she had planned it herself, people have been showing up in the most amazing ways. Meals have been dropped off with little notes and memories, phone calls and emails sharing anecdotes and stories from Eleanor's past. Her community extends well beyond North Vancouver, and we can see it today with all of you here. We have guests joining us today to honor Eleanor's life from all around the world. We invite you to write the name of the city in the chat box on your right so that we can see how far her love extended. Before we hear from those who loved her, I wanted to share a poem that so eloquently captures a life like Eleanor's. Do not stand at my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on snow. I am the sunlight on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift uplifting rush of quiet birds in circle flight. I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I am not there. I did not die. Now, I'm going to invite you to do our welcome ritual as we join in from all over the world. I hope everyone has a candle with you. And if you don't, just imagine you're lighting the candle all together. I'm going to invite you all to take your matches, your lighter, and we'll light the candle together. As you light it, take a moment and reflect on your connection with Eleanor. The scent from the candle and the small amount of heat that it's sending out will hopefully help you feel connected to one another and to Eleanor as we honor her life together. You can put your candle aside and keep it burning for the remainder of our celebration of Eleanor's life. Eleanor's daughters invited everyone to bring an object that reminded you of Eleanor. I'd like to ask everyone to find your object, and for a moment, we're going to hold it up for the screen so that we can all take a moment and see what everyone chose to bring. We're going to hear from a few of you who are going to share the story behind your object. And if you would like to share in a quieter way, you're more than welcome to write a little note in the chat box with what your object is and if there's a story attached to it. We also welcome you to email Eleanor's daughters and their family later on to share the story. If everyone can take your object, hold it up to the screen so we can all see. Make it a gallery view. There we go. And I see in the chat box we've got a few people that would like to share the stories. So, Christina, would you like to share your story?
For sure. I brought the mug that I'm using for today's tea ritual at the very end, because Eleanor loved not only visiting England, but she loved Harry and Meghan and loved everything about Harry and Meghan. And hopefully you can see this. You can read it, and it's a caricature and was a souvenir that was gifted to me, but I felt that with her love of the royal family and us all being here today, that it would be really special for me to bring. So that's my object.
Thank you, Christina. Now I see that Fawn has a story that she would like to share with us all. Fawn, let us know what you brought today.
Well, not sure if many of you know, but Eleanor was a fan of fashion. And on the tennis court, she was always dressed to a T and was not only my mentor in my tennis game, she also taught me how to have a little bit of style while playing. And she gave me this Pucci scarf. And I've always found it to be so precious and just a beautiful reminder that no matter what we're doing, we can always leave our mark of style and we can always take some pride in the way that we present ourselves to the world every day, whether we're on the tennis court or anywhere.
Thank you, Fawn. It's a beautiful memory. And I think everyone can nod in agreement thinking back to Eleanor's life in that way. Ariel, would you like to share a story?
Sure. Thank you for the chance. So I brought this Matryoshka doll. And this is something that Auntie Ellie, as I fondly called her, she had brought me back from one of her trips. And I just remember as a young child really loving to take it apart. And I sort of felt like this was a way to uncover more about her, just like there were different layers in the doll, that it was a chance for me to understand more about who she was.
I love that. Thank you. Thanks everyone for sharing. And as I mentioned, we'd love to hear from all of you. So feel free to add your story in the chat or send it out afterward. I think it's such a good reminder of the way that Eleanor touched all of our lives in different ways. We do have these memories and storytellers around our home and in our lives. It's obvious that we all have a deep connection to Eleanor and that her story is woven into our story. We will now hear from Gail, one of Eleanor's daughters. I'm going to share a little bit about her mom.
So first, thank you for coming and thank you for everyone who just shared their memories. It meant so much for me to hear all of those extra pieces that I sometimes don't remember or didn't know about my mother. It means so much to have her friends here today. I know she would have enjoyed seeing you all together. As much as it hurts that she's gone, I know that she would love to see the new friendships that will undoubtedly grow from this moment. My mom was so full of life, and I know that her memory lives on in the hearts of the countless people she impacted. A few of my favorite memories include growing up with the sea and watching my parents walk across the coast. Her ability to attract people and connect them and bring them into song is something that I have truly enjoyed carrying into my own life. And so her singing memories of singing our favorite songs together is something that I will never forget. I also loved watching her cruise through the tea shops and picking out her favorite brews to have in her daily ritual and sitting in her favorite corner with a steaming cup of tea and a smile on her face. I'll miss seeing that, and I'll miss having tea with her. I want people to remember her joy and passion of caring for others and her joyful approach to life. It just means so much that everyone's here today to celebrate her with me and my sister.
Thank you, Gail, for sharing some beautiful memories of your mom, and I think we all can feel connected to her through your words. We're now going to hear from Kate, one of Eleanor's granddaughters. She's going to share a few stories about her grandmother.
Hello. So we called her Granny Al, and I'm here representing the grandchildren and her great-grandchildren. And upon hearing about Granny Al's passing, I reached out to my cousins to hear their stories. And one pattern that emerged were the sensory experiences of Granny Al that we shared, the objects, the smells, and what we hear when we think of her. So when we see objects we associate with Granny Al, we see board games like Romoli, Scrabble, and cribbage. We see tennis balls and tennis whites. We see mittens, socks, blankets, sweaters, and anything knit, usually with hearts. We see high heels, dresses, hats, gloves, and costume jewelry, and we see beach glass collected, blue always being her favorite. Then we think about the sounds of Granny Al. We hear, good for you, dear. She was joyous, and she always said everything was wonderful. We hear classical music and church hymns on Sunday and Alvin and the Chipmunks records on replay. We hear the dinner bell, the crack of pulling the Christmas crackers, laughter around a dinner table. And we hear Granny Al's voice reading us the adventures of Winnie the Pooh and Tigger. Finally, we remember the smells of Granny. We remember the smell of rare roast beef in the oven. We smell hibiscus, Bermuda pine, and the ocean. We smell the leather interior of her car. We smell smart food popcorn and the snacks that were served at a prerequisite drinking hour. We smell barbecue, chlorine, and the smell of a lovely summer day by the pool or the ocean. And we smell, basically simply put, the scent of Granny Al. All these senses together have created a lifetime of memories woven together. On our grandmother-granddaughter trip to Paris, Granny Al told me she grew up in a time when children were supposed to be seen but not heard. In Granny Al's world, children were seen, heard, honored, spoiled, and treated with the utmost love. Granny Al, your legacy lives on in each of us. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. It's a very sensory experience you're able to paint for all of us. I think we can all picture her and the impact that she's had on so many lives. I know from talking with people that one of her favorite songs was Somewhere Over the Rainbow, and I would like everyone to just kind of take a moment and think of that song inside your head and just have this reflection of the rainbow somewhere showing up and a symbol, being a symbol of Eleanor's life. Next, we're going to do another little ritual to honor our connection to Eleanor. I'd like to invite everybody to close your eyes. Might feel a little bit uncomfortable at first, but wherever you are, just settle in a little bit and close your eyes and think about a time when you were together with Eleanor and she was being completely herself. Try to picture where she was in your memory. What was she doing or saying that stuck out in your mind? Was it a regular day, or had something important just happened? Who all was there? Can you picture any other details, like what she was wearing, or what the weather was like outside? Most importantly, how did she make you feel? Sit with that feeling for a moment, and try to distill that feeling down to one word. When you're ready, you can open your eyes and write down that one word on a piece of paper. Write it in big, bold letters. And when everyone is complete, we're going to hold up our words to the screen so that everyone can see the sea of words that represents Eleanor and how she made us all feel. I'm going to ask Christina to put us into gallery view so we can all see the words. And as soon as you're ready, hold your word and your paper up to the screen and take a moment to see all the words. I see grace and graceful and beautiful and curious and vibrant and loved, prized, and loved again. And loving. A lot of similarities and a lot of patterns here. Obviously, her effect on all of us was very similar. I invite you to write your word in the chat box, and we're going to hold on to those for Eleanor's family for another time. So whenever they feel like they're missing her, they can touch back onto these words. Now for our final story of the afternoon, we're going to hear from Allie, Eleanor's other daughter. Allie?
Hello. I love that exercise. That was so wonderful. I'm really excited to see all of the words in person. That'll be so great. So much has been shared already, and so I wanted to, rather than trying to summarize all the things that made Eleanor who she was, as so many people have said so eloquently, I thought I would just share a personal story, especially as she got older in life, for how I remember her. So the object that I brought was a photo of my children, and you know, as she reached the end of her life, she would constantly be sending me in the mail clippings of local newspaper articles that included two children that looked nothing like my own, but of course she was sure looked exactly like the kids, and she just had to send it over. And I remember this fondly. You know,
I always thought it was funny, but the thing that it really told me about her was how much, you know, her family was constantly in her mind and in her heart, and that no matter what she was reading, she was seeing her own family through the eyes of the different stories that she was writing. That's something that that I'll definitely miss receiving from her in the mail, but something that will always make me smile looking back on. And you know, it's just so wonderful to see so many people here that have had these different roles and experiences with her, and just really, really means a lot for our family to have everyone here together today. Thank you.
Beautiful. Thank you, Allie. So we're going to do one final toast to Eleanor, and then we're going to open it up for everyone to just kind of come in and out of conversation and spend a little bit more informal time sharing memories and stories. And we'll leave you through that. But before we get there, as it's been mentioned, Eleanor loved her kappa. She loved the warmth of the tea and her daily ritual. But it was more than a drink for her, it was an experience. Having a kappa involved several steps. First, she would boil the water to just the right temperature. And then she would let the tea steep for exactly 2 minutes. And then she would take that first sip, careful not to burn her mouth. So I hope everyone has a teacup. And again, if you've forgotten it, not to worry, just picture it. Hold your imaginary teacup up and take a sip with us. If everyone can take your teacup, take your tea bag, steep it in the water, and hold it for a moment. To smell that wonderful aroma. Take a moment of silence to honor Eleanor and her impact on all of our lives. And well, cheers to Eleanor. Wonderful thing about this ritual, and you'll feel it as the warmth of the tea settles into your body and you remember times that you spent with Eleanor. You can thank her for what she brought to your life, and you can remember that whenever you miss her, whenever you're wanting to feel connected, you can go into your kitchen, boil some water, steep a tea bag for exactly 2 minutes, and pour a kappa in her honor and feel connected to her. Eleanor dedicated so much of her time and love supporting the Lionsgate Hospital Foundation. And we've set up a special fund in her memory to support the families that she spent so much of her life trying to support. We'll post the link in the chat box, and we'll also include information about the fund in an email that will be sent out to everyone. We're now going to hear a final song. The song was Eleanor's favorite because it reminded her of England, her homeland. Growing up, she loved the Beatles, and every time one of their songs came on, she would start to smile and instantly tap her finger to the beat. This song in particular holds special meaning because it reminded her that even when we're far apart, we're always connected, and there will always be good times ahead. She lived her life that way, always hopeful and always full of sunshine. That was wonderful. What a beautiful song. Thank you all for joining us today. It's been an honor to hold space for Eleanor's life and for her friends and family. You'll now have time to share stories as a community, to visit and connect with one another, or to simply sit back and soak it all in. We'll unmute everyone so you can join in the conversation as you choose. You can also leave messages in the chat box. And when you're ready to exit the celebration of life today, when you're ready to leave the chat, just take your candle, hold it up to the screen, and blow it out. No need for goodbyes. You'll find a way to get in touch at some point, I'm sure. So thank you so much for coming together today to honor a life so well lived. Thank you.